Third place for Cameron. Great battle with Josh. But did you know that you were battling with him, but that you had a time penalty?
Yeah. I knew straight away. As the lights went out, I knew I jump started, and then saw my number up on the yellow board, and I kind of figured what was going on. And Josh did have some really good pace at the end there. I was kind of struggling to hold on to the back of him, and I had a few big moments. And right then, because I knew even if I did make the pass, it wouldn't have changed anything, I just kind of decided to settle down a little bit. But, you know, at the same time, I kind of chilled for a couple laps, and then I remember I was like, I still got to beat the guys by 5 seconds behind me. So I put my head down again. But, they held the lights for a long, long time, and SDK just crept next to me, and I kind of went off of his movement. But, stoked to be back up on the podium. So hopefully we don't do the same stupid mistake tomorrow.
Is it hard when you have that penalty? Are you like doing math in your head and stuff, or you just like forget it and just ride as hard as you can?
Yeah, honestly, at that point, I was like, it is what it is, you know, just go do your job and put your head down and ride as hard as you can. So, a bummer knowing like the whole race, you're just racing the whole race, knowing you got a 5 second penalty, it kind of sucks. But, bike felt like it was working really, really good. Work on a few things and try to be a little bit better tomorrow.
Okay, thank you. Second place today, Josh Herron. It's his sixth podium of the year. As far as I can tell, you've got 1 point lead in the championship, so all in all, a good day for you. Same question. Did you know he was penalized?
I saw him in SDK, like, creep at the beginning. But I just saw plus, like, whatever it was on my board, like, plus, I don't know, for some reason I thought I saw, like, plus 2.5, which wouldn't have made sense because he had a five-second penalty. I don't know. I was just in my head. I was like, what's going on? I had a feeling that that's what it was from, but I was trying to shake my head at him to, like, just let me focus on what I got to do in front of me instead of what's behind me, because I knew he was there no matter what. It's not like I'm going to slow down, because I raced here last year with broken ankle, so I know it's difficult track for your ankle, and, you know, I don't – obviously, you're just your foot in general. So I just kept pushing as hard as I could just in case something happened at the end and he started fading a little bit that I was there. I didn't want to worry about what my gap was to the guy behind me. But he never got it, and it just stayed plus five. But I figured, you know, about halfway through, I'm like, all right, that must be what it's for. But like I said, wanted to just every time Cam went by me, I just would, you know, fight right back just in case I could make some way on Bobier at the front. But he was just riding too good today, so it wasn't possible. Just hoping that tomorrow can be a little bit better.
Do you think there's things you can do to get closer tomorrow with the bike?
My biggest problem, which everybody seemed to be struggling with rear grip at the beginning of the race, but I don't understand why. You know, the track temp was two Celsius down from what it was yesterday, and the tire didn't feel like that yesterday. It only took two laps to come in, where today it seems like it took six, seven, eight laps for it to really come in. I just couldn't get comfortable with it until like halfway through. But then halfway came and I just started getting achy and couldn't ride the bike how I wanted to ride it because I was getting tired. So I'd like to think that, you know, maybe we just had a pressure problem or something. You know, I don't know. I hope we can be there. But you know, Cam's had that. I've seen all weekend he's, like, been putting red sectors together but then leaving the last one a little bit, you know, leaving a little bit there on the table. So I had a feeling he had some pace that he was kind of hiding a little bit. And then this morning in qualifying, he really, you know, banged one out. So we got to go back to the drawing board and see if we can – even if I can get 2/10, like, that'd be great, because just – getting beat 2/10 every lap, like, it just starts to put a strain on your mental, you know, mental side. So, hopefully we can, because I don't want to finish second. But like you said, 1 point lead in the championship. I'm happy about that with three rounds to go, and just hoping we can chip away a little bit more tomorrow.
Okay, thank you. Our winner today, Cameron Bobier. It's his fourth win of the year, 63rd career AMA Superbike win, so you keep piling those up. It's kind of hard to believe that you have more wins in this series than anybody else at this point, considering what you've been through. The heel obviously feels good enough to ride the way that you're riding. Is it a case of, like, lack of training? I mean, are you physically getting tired by the end of the race?
Do I look tired?
No, you look great.
No, to be honest, I'm pretty tired. But, the last month has been a roller coaster, man. Just, you know, from breaking my heel and flying straight down to Dr. Brian to get it fixed and, then watching these guys race at Brainerd, just knowing how good we started the season and how good I was feeling on the bike and how hard the team's been working, to just see it like thrown away in front of me was pretty tough. But like I said before, I saw the points going into Ridge, and I felt like, you know, if I could just go get a couple points there, and we could be in contention towards the end of the year, just with the way everything's shaken out. But today, I just yesterday felt amazing just to ride the bike like I know how to ride it, and I can ride. You know, at 100%, I can push. I can. I feel good. Yeah, I'm definitely struggling a little bit with my fitness because I haven't done anything in the past month. I've ridden the bicycle a couple times and been to the gym a couple times, but definitely not my normal program. But it feels amazing to get this today.
Is it? Can you ride the bicycle?
Yeah, I can. I can ride it. I've slowly just. Not fast or nothing, but I can get it moving. Get some swing.
Mm. All right. Well, you were 55 points down coming in, and you're 41 points down now. So, I mean, it works in your favor, the fact that everything's so competitive. You know what I mean? Josh could get fifth tomorrow, or Cameron could win. You know what I mean? It's like there's so many guys going fast that's got to help you in a way, be able to maybe fight back into this thing.
It is. You know, we still got quite a bit of chunk to the front guys because, I mean, it's 1, 2, 3 is they're separated by a point or something. So definitely got to go to work and put our heads down and stay on two wheels. That's the number one thing right now. But it is. I mean, it's tough. Don't get me wrong, but it's pretty cool just being a part of this championship battle. And, you know, these guys are riding so good. I was honestly pretty surprised to see a gap there at the beginning of the race, just because I saw how much pace both these guys had in practice. And same with Sean and same with Bob Fong. So, we'll see what tomorrow brings, and just keep working hard and see how it goes.
All right. Well, thank you. Any questions?
Mason Blue, Monterey Herald. A question for Josh. Race weekends always bring a certain amount of pressure regardless, but to what extent is this heightened on a day like this where there's such a close title fight?
You're asking how much more pressure is added because of the tight fight in the championship? I think, you know, at the end of the day, I think it helps that it's tight because you don't have time to like really think about the lead or anything like that. Like if you're in the lead by a lot, then it's, I think, more stressful because you're thinking about it a lot, where we just all need to beat each other. Like, you know, so I think at the end of the day, it makes it a little bit easier for us.
I guess I'll need that with the noise. Cameron, I wanted to ask you about your qualifying lap. So, you know, obviously Josh had that sense 2018, every time we came in here, I was thinking, is anybody going to, you know, get to there? And then we heard the track's pretty bumpy this year, so there haven't been many records broken this weekend, but you actually broke the record. So did that surprise you? I mean, when you were on that lap, did it feel like you were really hauling it on that one?
I mean, yeah, I felt super dialed in, honestly. I felt like I nailed everything really good. Normally, on the qualifying tire compared to the race tire at other tracks, it's pretty tough for me to go faster. Just the way, I don't know, maybe it's the way I ride or the way my bike is set up wise. But here, I think we definitely could have raced a softer compound, but no one knew how the track was compared to last year. I think last year it was, you know, it was tearing up stuff pretty good. It was literally brand new the week before we came here. So right. No one really knew what to expect, but I think we could have almost raced the Super Pole tire compound.
Wow. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, guys. Thanks.